A very good morning. You're watching Rajya Sabha Television. I'm Smriti Rastogi with Breakfast News. Let's begin the bulletin with the top headlines of this morning. Prime Minister Narendra Modi to hold talks with Myanmar State Councillor Aung San Suu Kyi. Several agreements expected to be signed. Issue of Rohingyas to be raised. India issues demand to Pakistan over August 26 attack in Pulwama, asks it to bring justice those responsible for the attack that claimed lives of 8 security men. Over 2 lakh firms deregistered for failing to comply with regulatory requirements. Centre asks authorities to restrict operations of their bank accounts. U.S. President scraps Obama-era amnesty program for young immigrants, move likely to impact more than 7,000 Indian Americans. And extremely dangerous Hurricane Irma strengthens into Category 5 storm, moves towards the Caribbean and southern United States. Prime Minister Narendra Modi is on the second leg of his two-nation visit to Myanmar. This is his first bilateral visit to the neighbouring nation. The Prime Minister is scheduled to hold wide-ranging talks with State Councillor Aung San Suu Kyi today morning. The two leaders are also expected to sign agreements after the talks. Suu Kyi is also hosting a lunch for Prime Minister today. On Tuesday, Prime Minister Modi met Myanmar President Thin Kyo, where both leaders discussed steps to deepen India and Myanmar's historical relationship. Prime Minister Modi also gifted him a sculpture of Bodhi tree and a reproduction of a 1841 map of the stretch of River Salween. After concluding his engagements in Nay Pi Taw, Modi will travel to Bagan, where India is involved in a development project. According to reports, the issue most likely to dominate PM's trip to Myanmar will be the deportation of thousands of Rohingya Muslim refugees from India. Ahead of his Myanmar visit in China, India and China decided to shun differences and move forward on the path of cooperation. Meeting on the sidelines of the BRICS summit in Xiamen, Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Chinese President Xi Jinping also agreed to play to each other's strengths to encourage cooperation. Both decided to let the Doklam issue be dealt by border mechanisms and let business and trade flourish instead of conflict and confrontation.
Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Chinese President Xi Jinping held their first bilateral talks after the Doklam border standoff on Tuesday. The hour-long meeting included discussions on economic, security and strategic issues. Injecting a positive note to the meeting, Prime Minister Modi congratulated the Chinese President for the successful conclusion of BRICS.
मैं समझता हूं कि तेज गति से बदलते वैश्विक परिवेश में ब्रिक्स को और अधिक प्रासंगिक बनाने में यह शिखर सम्मेलन सचमुच में बहुत सफल हुआ है.
The last bilateral meeting between the two leaders was in June in Astana, where they decided not to turn differences in disputes. The Chinese president also appreciated Modi's efforts for peace between the two Asian giants. He clearly said China was ready to work with India on the basis of Panjshir agreement. Both leaders agreed on the need for engagement at all levels, especially on security issues. They also recognized that the border issues were an important aspect of their differences and should not be allowed to flare up in the manner it did over Doklam.
Both of us know what happened. Okay, so this was not a backwards looking conversation. This was a forward looking conversation. The sense of it was, how do we take the relationship forward? How do we ensure that there is peace and tranquility on the border areas to ensure that the relationship stays forward? How do we ensure that mutual contacts and mutual trust is strengthened so that peace and tranquility on the border areas? So that was the direction in which the conversation was.
China also gave an indication of its changed stance at the BRICS summit when it agreed on the Xiamen Declaration that criticized terrorist groups being sheltered in Pakistan. The bilateral meeting was also a strong affirmation of the recognition at the leadership level to keep the relationship on an upward trajectory.
Chinese foreign minister contends that India should appreciate China's development in a positive manner. But Indian officials say that China also must understand the importance of India in the world, and China should not encroach into the strategic space of India. If both countries appreciate each other's concerns, it will be a win-win situation. Akhilesh Suman for Raj Sabha Television with camera person Om Prakash in Delhi.
And after pitching strongly for peace at the Xiamen BRICS meeting, Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Tuesday followed up by suggesting 10 Nobel commitments to BRICS leaders to achieve global transformation. Prime Minister Modi was speaking at the BRICS Emerging Markets and Developing Countries Dialogue in Xiamen City of China.
Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Tuesday pitched for coordinated action on counter-terrorism, cyber-security and disaster management. Speaking at the BRICS Emerging Markets and Developing Countries Dialogue in Xiamen, Modi suggested 10 commitments for global transformation.
I had spoken about the BRICS driving the global transformation in the next 10 years for it to be a golden decade. I suggest that this can be brought about with our proactive approach, policies and actions on the following 10 noble commitments.
The Prime Minister also said the development agenda of BRICS countries lies with Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas. He urged the BRICS nations to work collectively for a digital world, skilled world and healthier world.
The countries present here together represent almost half of the humanity. Whatever we do will impact the world sustainably. So it is our solemn duty to make a better world, brick by brick, through BRICS.
Besides Modi, leaders of Brazil, Russia, China, South Africa and five guest countries, Egypt, Tajikistan, Thailand, Mexico and Kenya attended the dialogue. Akhilesh Suman's report for Rajya Sabha TV.
And amid mounting international pressure to act against terror groups, Pakistan has rejected a declaration by the BRICS nations that includes China, saying there was no safe haven for terrorists on its soil. Leaders from Brazil, Russia, India, China and South Africa condemned terrorism in all its forms and manifestations on Monday, also expressing concern over the threat posed by terror groups, including those based in Pakistan. The 43-page declaration expressed concern over security situation in the region and the violence caused by the Taliban, Islamic State, Al-Qaeda and its affiliates. External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj is in Russian port city of Vladivostok on a three-day visit. She took part in the opening ceremony of Third Eastern Economic Forum, which is deliberating pressing issues relating to global trade. Sushma Swaraj will also hold bilateral talks with her Russian counterpart Sergei Lavrov, during which various issues relating to trade, investment and defense cooperation are likely to figure. The Eastern Economic Forum is considered as the biggest international communication platform for cooperation between businesses leaders and senior government representatives from Russia, the Pacific region and the Association of Southeast Asian Nations. Delegates from at least 24 countries, including the US, Japan, China, Australia, Canada, Britain and Germany, are attending the gathering. Swaraj's trip to Russia follows the visit of Prime Minister Narendra Modi as guest of honor at St. Petersburg International Economic Forum in June.
तीन वर्ष के थोड़े से समय में न केवल रूस के सुदूरपूर्व क्षेत्र की आर्थिक ताकत को दर्शाने वाला बल्कि एशिया प्रशांत क्षेत्र तथा विश्व के अन्य हिस्सों से भी नेताओं तथा कारोबारी प्रतिनिधियों को एक साथ लाने वाला एक प्रमुख मंच बन गया है। इस मंच का तेजी से हो रहा विकास इस बात का प्रमाण है कि रूस के सुदूर पूर्व में निवेश के तथा व्यवसाय के बहुत अवसर बढ़े हैं।
India and Japan have resolved to further strengthen military cooperation. The two countries held wide-ranging talks on bilateral defense and security ties. A range of bilateral regional issues relating to security and defense were discussed during the talks between Defense Minister Arun Jaitley and his Japanese counterpart. Jaitley also called on Japanese Prime Minister Shinzo Abe and discussed ways to deepening defense and security cooperation. The annual Indo-Japan Ministerial Defense Dialogue took place at a time when tension was mounting in the region due to North Korea's nuclear pursuits and China's growing assertiveness in the South China Sea.
I think both with regard to terrorism and also proliferation of nuclear technologies and missiles in this region is a matter of mutual concern to both Japan and India.
北朝鮮の防衛を食い止めることができるかどうかは、国際社会が連携、連帯していくことに関わっています。今後、インドと協力をしながら、緊密に連携しながらですね、北朝鮮の政策を変えさせていきたいと思います。
On to some more news. President Ram Nath Kovind has asked teachers not to commercialize education. He said there would be no difference between them and traders if they indulge in such activities. Addressing the recipients of the National Awards for Teachers at Darbar Hall of Rashtrapati Bhavan, the president said that teachers' fraternity must impart education not to make their students doctors or engineers, but to groom them to become a good human being first, he said. He also underlined that education was never sold or commercialized in the Indian tradition and was considered as Vidya Dhan.
ये शिक्षक मूल रूप से जो उनका दायित्व मिला है किसी बच्चे का जीवन संवारने का वो बहुत बड़ा दायित्व माँ बाप से भी बढ़कर के दायित्व और इसीलिए कभी कभी मैं कहता हूं यू ले द फाउंडेशन ऑफ ए चाइल्ड ए फाउंडेशन नींव का पत्थर वो एक बच्चा हो सकता है लेकिन नींव का पत्थर रखना है किस तरीके से रखना है वो यदि सोचता है कि इस बच्चे का भविष्य का यहाँ से आज से लेकर के और लगभग इस राष्ट्र को समर्पित करने की जो भावना है उस बच्चे में वो आगामी इस देश में 80-90 साल तक यदि वो सेवा कर सकता है राष्ट्र को समर्पण के साथ में वो जो नींव का पत्थर एक बच्चा हो सकता है लेकिन उस पत्थर को रखने का काम जो है वो शिक्षक का है
Meanwhile, Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu on Tuesday underscored the need to achieve 100% literacy in the next 5 years. Honoring teachers on Teachers' Day, he said both central and state governments must pay special attention to popularize the study of one's mother tongue. He also inaugurated the Diksha portal for teachers.
Sammanit Shikshak Bandhuon.
On the occasion of Teachers' Day, Vice President Venkaiah Naidu presented the National Award to Teachers 2016 at Vigyan Bhavan.
Shrimati Nalle Boina Vimla Kumari.
Underscoring the crucial role that teachers play in building the country's future, the Vice President said over the next few years, government, leaders and society have to make a collective effort to achieve 100% literacy.
I hope that the government will take all the steps that no children will be allowed to stay out of school. That should be the mission of the government. That should be the duty of all the people. It is not the duty of teacher alone. It is the duty of all enlightened citizens, the parents, the public representatives, MLAs, MPs, ministers. Everybody should get involved into this and see to it that we achieve 100% literacy rate.
Vice President Naidu also emphasized the need to learn local and regional languages in the early stages of education. A portal named Diksha was inaugurated on the occasion to enable teachers to access courses via YouTube.
और उनका साथ देंगे हम सब मिलकर. दीक्षा, National Digital Infrastructure for Teachers.
Union HRD Minister Prakash Javadekar appealed to teachers to provide good education to all.
कि जो 10 लाख सरकारी स्कूल्स हैं, आज लोग मानते हैं कि प्राइवेट निजी स्कूल अच्छे हैं. हम कहते हैं कि निजी स्कूल अच्छे होंगे तो सरकारी स्कूल भी अच्छे होंगे, दोनों में प्रतिस्पर्धा होगी. सबको शिक्षा, अच्छी शिक्षा, इसी तरफ हमें जाना है और इसलिए एजुकेट टू एम्पावर.
Many teachers gave suggestions to improve the quality of education.
हम बच्चों को विद्यालय तक लाएं और उसके लिए सबसे जरूरी है कि हम बच्चों को इतना मोटिवेशनल तरीके से पढ़ाएं, इतने इनोवेटिव तरीके से पढ़ाएं कि बच्चे कॉन्वेंट स्कूल को छोड़ करके यहाँ आना स्वीकार करें.
शिक्षक का दायित्व बढ़ गया है. एक गुरु जिसको कि ब्रह्मा विष्णु महेश और सत्य की धरती के लिए कहा जाता है, आज उस गुरु को अपनी गरिमा बनाने की जरूरत है.
The National Award aims to give public recognition to meritorious teachers working in primary, middle and secondary schools. The awards were instituted in 1958. Out of the 374 awards, 20 are reserved for Sanskrit, Persian and Arabic teachers. Panchanan Mishra's report for Rajya Sabha TV.
And several dignitaries called on Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu on Tuesday. The Supreme Court Judge Justice R. Bhanumati, the Chief Justice of Bombay High Court, Justice Manjula and Attorney General of India Shri K.K. Venugopal called on Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu at his residence. The Minister of State for Shipping and Finance P. Radhakrishnan also met the Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu. The Union Minister for Agriculture and Farmers Welfare Shri Radha Mohan Singh was also among those who called on the Vice President. And with that, time for a very short break. More news and updates on the other side. Stay with us.
Harappan sites are a treasure trove of sophisticated pottery. These creations show tremendous advances by the potter's weave. Creations like the perforated jar, the copper axe, the chisel and knives astound even present-day archaeologists. Figurines depicting yoga poses, chess pieces display a complexity unsurpassed even by later-day civilizations, all of which make the Harappan civilization truly unique.
Welcome back. India summoned the acting High Commissioner of Pakistan and issued a demarche over the infiltration by a group of GGM terrorists. The terrorists killed 8 security personnel in Jammu and Kashmir's Pulwama last month. The Ministry of External Affairs lodged a strong protest with acting High Commissioner Haider Shah over the terror attack on August 26th. In a statement, the MEA said Pakistan was asked to investigate the incident and bring to justice the individuals and entities responsible for orchestrating it. The MEA said it was conveyed to the envoy that DNA samples of the neutralized terrorist have been preserved and can be made available for investigation in Pakistan. India has also asked Pakistan to abide by its commitment to not allow territory under its control to be used for terrorism. A national investigation agency has arrested 2 persons, including a freelance photojournalist who allegedly indulged in stone pelting and mobilized support against security personnel through social media. According to the NIA, both were involved in stone pelting incidents, besides organizing groups of youths who would throw stones at security personnel involved in counterinsurgency operations. The two will be produced before a special NIA court in New Delhi today. This was the first time that the NIA made an arrest from South Kashmir after filing a case in which the leader of the Pakistan-based Jamaat-ul-Dawa banned terrorist outfit Lashkar-e-Taiba, Hafiz Saeed, was named as an accused. And senior Kannada journalist, activist Gauri Lankesh was shot dead by unidentified assailants outside her residence in Bengaluru on Tuesday night. 55-year-old Gauri Lankesh was opening the gate of her house in Rajeshwari Nagar when motorcycle-borne assailants fired at her indiscriminately. She died on the spot as two bullets hit her in the chest and one on her forehead. Police suspect that she was under surveillance of assailants who must have trailed her closely. The slain journalist edited Kannada tabloid Gauri Lankesh Patrike besides owning some of the publications. Chief Minister Siddaramaiah has termed her death shocking. The Chief Minister said three police teams have been constituted to probe the killing and bring the culprits to book at the earliest.
There we have already formed three special teams. One team headed by the Joint Commissioner of Crime Branch, Satish Kumar. Another team headed by the ACP Kengerigate, headed by ACP Chikpet. Now, she is alone at home. Nobody else is there. Regarding the CC footage, the cameras are there. The CC footage will be recorded inside. That being a scene of crime, with the forensic experts only, we will be attending to this investigation matter.
On to some more news. Over 2 lakh firms have been struck off from registrar of companies for failing to comply with regulatory requirements. This comes as government continues its crackdown on shell companies, which are allegedly used as conduits for illicit fund flows and tax evasion. The government also initiated authorities concerned to restrict operations of their bank accounts. According to reports, the names of 209,032 companies have been struck off from the registrar of the companies. The existing directors and authorized signatories of such struck off companies will now become ex-directors and ex-authorized signatories. The Department of Financial Services has advised banks that they should take immediate steps to put restrictions on bank accounts of such struck off companies. And shifting our focus onto the international front, US President Donald Trump has announced termination of a program that protected undocumented immigrants called Dreamers who were brought to us as children. Trump justified the policy shift by describing a constitutional misstep on the part of the Obama administration. The onus is now on Congress to address the situation of 8 lakh Dreamers and all 11 million undocumented immigrants in US legislatively before they are exposed to the threat of deportation.
Has announced the end of DACA or deferred action for childhood arrivals. The program that had protected nearly 8 lakh young undocumented immigrants brought to the United States as children from deportation. President Donald Trump blamed former President Barack Obama for creating the program through executive authority and urged Congress to come up with a solution. While existing recipients of DACA will see no impact for at least 6 months, no new applications can now be made.
People think in terms of children, but they're really young adults. I have a love for these people, and hopefully now Congress will be able to help them and do it properly.
In the 5 years since DACA was enacted, the nearly 8 lakh individuals who have received the protections, called Dreamers, have started families, pursued careers, and studied in schools and universities across the U.S. The Trump administration pitched his action as the least disruptive option available after DACA was challenged in several courts. However, Obama criticized it, calling it cruel.
Today's September 5th deadline was set by the plaintiffs presenting the administration with two and only two real options to choose from: the likely sudden cancellation of the program by a judge, or an orderly wind down that preserves the rule of law and returns the question to the legislative branch where it belongs. The president chose the latter of the two options.
House Democratic leader Nancy Pelosi also slammed the decision and called on majority Republicans in Congress to join Democrats in moving to safeguard DACA recipients. Two senators from the opposing parties also called for bipartisan legislation to protect Dreamers. The Mexican government said it regretted the scrapping of DACA and would step up its consular work on behalf of its citizens who are affected.
For those young men and women across America, I can tell you this is a moment of great concern, great fear, and great anxiety about what's going to happen to their lives.
Meanwhile, protests were held in several U.S. cities after the announcement, with police in New York making at least a dozen arrests when protesters rallied in front of Trump Tower.
I just feel really powerless because I feel as American as anybody else, right? And for him to say that I came here to steal jobs and remove the opportunities for American citizens, I feel betrayed.
Trump took a hard line on immigration while campaigning last year and promised to scrap DACA if elected. And the decision, while throwing future of DACA recipients to House and Senate, also raises the specter of a protracted showdown over immigration, an issue that has haunted Washington for decades. Bureau report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Meanwhile, the U.S. continues to push for tougher sanctions against North Korea, saying that denuclearization of the Korean Peninsula is high on its priority. U.S. Ambassador to the United Nations, Nikki Haley, said that more sanctions on North Korea may not change the country's behavior, but would cut off funding for its ballistic missile and nuclear programs. Meanwhile, the White House said all options other than talks are on the table to deal with North Korea, including diplomatic and economic measures. Russian President Vladimir Putin, however, has called sanctions against North Korea senseless, saying sanctions won't force North Korea to abandon its nuclear program. North Korea's ambassador to the UN in Geneva, Han Tae-song, said that it was proud of the hydrogen bomb test his country carried out. An extremely dangerous hurricane Irma strengthened into a Category 5 storm as it moves towards the Caribbean and the southern United States. The Dominican Republic, Antigua, Florida, Puerto Rico, the Virgin Islands and the other northern Caribbean states are on alert. Irma has a packing winds of 185 miles per hour. The hundreds of shelters are being prepared across the country in all the states to provide shelters to the victims if needed.
De la naturaleza. Con la naturaleza no hay control. Hay un constante monitoreo y depende prácticamente en un 90% de la población el hecho de que cuando se emiten los lineamientos de protección civil que van en procura de salvar vidas.
La pase es zona que libre al impacto pifoyo, c'est trois départements qui n'en noyo. Nord, nord-ouest, avec nord-est, avec certainement Haute-Tibonite et Plateau Central. Mais parallèlement à ça, ça ne va pas limiter à ça, c'est que nous connaissons que nous avons quand même une certaine vulnérabilité.
And after the culmination of 10-day Ganesh Chaturthi festival on Tuesday, devotees across India sang and danced as they carried idols of God Ganesha for immersion in rivers. The focus of the festival was Mumbai. Devotees made a beeline with huge idols of Ganesha, walking across streets or on trucks and other vehicles. We leave you with these visuals.
लाल चढ़ायो अच्छा गजमुख को चोंदिल लाल विराजे सुत गौरी हर को हाथ लिए गुड़ लड्डू साई सुरवर को महिमा कहे न जाए लागत हूँ पद को जय देव जय देव।